on her. What? She's gonna look like with a chimney on her.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher, and it burned.
Well, the very first official Tilton tour took place on Saturday, and off to the Opera we went, and oh my God, what a day out it was. The Motley Crue took off from Brum, looking like they were waiting for God. That all changed as soon as they pulled up at the Black Swan in Uttoxeter. Great to see so many lovely people grace my hometown. The beer started flowing, and so did the lovely sandwiches, so thanks to Mary for knocking them up for us. Probably the first ever proper invasion into Uttoxeter by the Blues, and how much we were accepted by the local Derby supporters. We had great conversation, a bit of banter, and even a team photo outside. Then on to the Tilton tour bus, and I forgot to hold onto my beer and had a lap full of it when the bus jerked. I won't be ringing claims direct, it's football. Then into the iPro, where we were received well by all the staff and had a great pre-match sing-off in the bar. Then that game, the game, one that will stick in my memory for many years to come. Nice to see also two of my lads getting there and making it as well. Perfect day, perfect result, and then there was our fans. They, ladies and gents, are one amazing set of away supporters. Just another amazing week being a Birmingham City fan.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, burns, burns.
An absolute massive welcome to the Tilton Talk Show this Monday evening. Sorry I couldn't make it last week, the brakes failed on my car. Well, what a weekend that was. In the studio tonight we've got the wonderful Mr. Brown.
Good evening.
We have also the madcap, unbelievable person. He's the mind of all knowledge. He just is one incredible, crazy, loopy, but very nice guy. Chris Pugh, welcome, mate. You knew that was coming, didn't you?
Yeah.
You knew that was coming. And we got some poor random Derby fan in the background as well. Look, lovely welcome back to our good friend Rockin Jonny.
Good evening.
Thank you.
There you go, Jonny, you've had the clap. You are a friend of the show, Jonny. It's good to have you back again with us.
Thank you very much indeed.
You don't need to hold the microphone, it's okay, it's perfect.
It's picking you up all right.
This is radio, this is radio.
We know it.
Well, what a day, Chris, what a day.
Yeah, it was
up there, wasn't it, mate?
Unbelievable.
Up there.
Yeah. I mean, on a purely footballing point of view, to go to a team like Derby and put in that performance was incredible. But obviously, you know, the whole day out organising with the Tilton Talk, the fans and everything on the bus up to Uttoxeter, and then making their way to the ground, and then, as you say, the game itself, and it was just a really momentous day.
Perfect day, wasn't it, mate? Perfect day.
It was a
great. We did it in style in that bus as well, didn't we, kid?
We did,
what a bus!
Yeah.
What a bus that is. Where did we get that from, Chris? Where did we get the bus from?
Brother organised that.
It's what a star he is.
Yeah, awesome.
Thanks, brother. Thanks for organising that. Perfect.
It was a great way to do it, and you know the game capped it all off, really. To, you know, as a first Tilton Talk away day that the whole lot of us have done together, it was you couldn't have asked for much more.
24 in the end, wasn't it? I think 24.
I think on the coach.
Yeah, 24. Yeah.
24 plus
yeah.
Your wife who went shopping. 25.
Yeah, so that's right. Yeah. That was 24, was that?
Of course, 24. Yeah, because my lad met us there, didn't he? Luke met us there. Yeah. I'd like to, and I genuinely mean this, Rockin. I'd like to pay a special thanks to Derby County Football Club, their hospitality, their staff, For me personally, right?
Yeah.
I thought they were brilliant. I thought that was cracking. Yeah, the girls were having a laugh, you know, serving the beers and this, that, and the other. And well, of course, we were all in there singing it, giving it large.
Yeah.
They all joined in. Bit of fun, bit of banter. Your experience?
Catering
was
a lot to be desired, I think.
I was just going to say the same. Yeah. Well, as a man who works in that industry, awful. Yeah.
I didn't indulge in the catering, so I can't.
Awful. I gave up twice.
If the away bar at Blues had run out of, completely run out of pies by 2:20.
Right,
I think somebody would be in for a serious talking to
3,089 Birmingham City fans in that end.
Even more reason to make sure that that bar is stocked to high heaven of stuff.
John, they knew. Your thoughts on that? You run out of food, mate. We're Brummies, we eat a lot, you know what I mean?
I never dined there anyway. Yeah.
You've never dined in the away end.
They knew 3,000 Blues fans were coming. And run out to get there at 20 past and say, "Oh, we got no pies." Oh, yeah. That is a schoolboy error. And then half time, no hot food at all.
The only thing I can say, because I didn't eat there, is that my only experience was with the girls. My only experience was with the girls who served behind the bar, and I must say they were very pleasant.
I don't blame them. Obviously, they can't do anything.
The stewards were very good. The police outside with his egg on his back, he was very good. What's all that about? What did he have an egg on his back for? I don't know.
Couldn't say that at all.
Bless him. But, anyway, we had the laugh, and the main thing is that it was an emphatic winning. You know, an incredible second half. Towards the Derby supporters as well.
You know, the performance in itself. I mean, I think the first half, from what my perspective of it, we almost sat there waiting for Derby to come at us, and then once it got to half time, I think Rowett and the team knew that they weren't going to come at us, and you know the performance that they were putting in, they never really had anything to throw at us. Their only threat, from where I was sitting, was Tom Ince on the left, occasionally getting the better of Grimes, but even when he got the better of him, they didn't really create a lot. I think there was one free header about 12 yards out, which was headed harmlessly wide. And then a couple of long range efforts, but like you say, we get to half time, and I think we've just said to ourselves, we might as well give this a go.
Give it a go, yeah.
They're not doing anything to harm us. We, you know, it's pretty comfortable, so we might as well give it a go. And right from the kickoff in the second half, you could tell that we were pressing faster, we were pressing higher, you know, and there was a bit more intensity in our play. And once we got the first goal, then. You know, Derby didn't really know what to do after that, and we controlled it from, you know, alright, they had a couple of sniffs in the last 5 minutes, but that's when you're 3-0 up, so.
Must apologise for the voice tonight. This is the result of it's a football related injury. I was called DJ Squeaky in the pub on Saturday night, that was it. So the voice is not at its best, but we'll get through. We'll get through, because that's what we do.
But we'll battle.
That's what we do, yeah. And then it was really nice as well for you all to come back and have another beer back at the pub, as well. And they've said passed on the best wishes to you all, and said what an enjoyable day it was for everybody. So it was good all round day out, a busting day out.
Yeah, it was.
You clinically dissected us. That's what it was
in that second half, without a doubt. Yeah.
What it was, Cyrus Christie's been our main thrusting player this season. And he didn't get a sniff against Jax Magoma.
Yeah.
He just didn't, and they were cancelled out territorially, man for man marking.
I wonder whether they were worried about Magoma going forward, so they sort of restricted Christie going forward.
Yeah.
Because they were worried about leaving Magoma a lot of space. But yeah. I mean, the second half, the amount of time. I mean, I love watching him play. Terrell.
He can either have a nightmare or an absolute beaut, can't he?
But when he's playing like that, and he's one of the only players in the Championship, you can tell he's too good for the Championship, and that, you know, he's come from Barcelona and he's an Arsenal player registered. Just the way he takes the ball, the way he collects, you know, the amount of times it comes to him on the halfway line. And so many players in the Championship, and even when you see the Premier League nowadays, they'll take a touch with their back to goal still. Whereas Terrell, he takes his touch on the turn. So when he's taking his first touch, he's running
halfway there. Yeah, he's halfway there. Yeah.
And it creates so much space for everybody else. You know, and when he's got the ball, you can see the Derby defenders kept backing off and backing off, and it gave Magoma and David Davis on the right. You know, if we did decide to go for it a bit more, we could have had Solomon Ottebor or Buckley maybe on the right wing rather than Davis, who would give us even more attacking impetus. But obviously the solidity we had to have in the first half, especially with Davis, Gleeson and Keefton Bowles, it really, you know, stunned Derby's attacking threat. And then but just the way Terrell takes the ball, it's effortless to watch, and
it was beautiful. A pleasure to watch that second half, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
The whole of it.
Yeah,
every bit of it was a pleasure to watch. Right. Harry BCFC, welcome to you 98. Who would you give man of the match to? I couldn't pick one out of the 11.
I mean, he didn't score, but just the way he threatened everybody, Terrell for me. Magoma had an excellent game.
Keith did.
Well, he probably deserves it for the goal alone. But yeah, for me personally,
that's actually going to go. It's got to go down as one of the goals of the season. Ooh. In the Championship.
Yeah, without a doubt.
It has. And the other one, to be perfectly honest with you.
Oh well, no, that was a cross.
It wasn't a cross. He meant it. He meant it. Cross or not, cross or not. I saw him. He had it all in his mind. I'll skim this off the side of my boot, and it might just loop over the goalie's head.
I'll probably give man of the match Terrell, but yeah.
Okay.
Terrell and Magoma.
Yeah.
Chalke says, "Well. Look who's jumped on the Ring of Fire bandwagon. I started that at Fulham last season, and now you play it. How come we're jumping on the bandwagon if only we played it once? It's not a bandwagon.
I don't quite understand it anyway.
No." You get it, Chris?
Yeah, I get it.
The other thing about the game is, you know, you're really panicking when you have a triple substitution
at one. Yeah,
that was
exactly,
a very strange substitution.
And the two players you bought off were the ones that thought were arguably the most threatening in the first half, in Ince and Russell.
Yeah,
you took them off, when you bought Martin on, it was like. The width had completely gone then.
Yeah.
For me, which made Caddis and Grounds' life a lot easier.
I think any chance of coming back had gone with that strange substitution.
And Donaldson was floating all over the pitch, dragging Keogh. Yeah. So there was nothing down the centre.
So
it was open.
What's normally a quite strong midfield for Derby, Butterfield came on as well, but you've got the likes of Thorne there as well. But as I say, Terrell got so much space in the middle of the park and ability to turn.
But he also created that space, though.
But they didn't do enough to stop Donaldson or Terrell.
A couple of comments from Blue Harbour. Hard to give man of the match to one player. The defence was solid. Grounds, he did a good job. And a job they took off Tom Ince. Yeah. And also, when I left the ground, I felt that we had more than 3 points, and I still feel like that now.
Where you feel like, that's a real statement.
Actually, I have to make a statement, right? I feel quite post Wembley X at the minute. I mean it, because I think it was because the whole day,
the whole experience
of the whole day. And I got goosebumps. There you go.
But you know, from a Championship size perspective, everybody else will have looked at that result come in. You know, it's not like we've gone there and snuck a 1-0.
No.
We've gone there and convincingly beat Derby 3-0 in their own
backyard. You tipped to go up at the beginning of the season.
I still think they should. Mm. They should be in the top four.
Now we rocked. See the pun there. We rocked their wheels off their bus last season with that 2-2 draw.
Yeah.
Do you think, Johnny, that we've done the same again with this 3-0? Because it was a decent beating after all.
Well, it was a clinical dissection. Mm. Oh, it was just.
But do you think we were talking, you know, just a little while earlier, about us from a Derby perspective, you got your chairman going into the dressing rooms to roast the manager and the players.
Yeah.
After the Reading game, you got a trip away to Dubai cancelled. You've just lost against, you know, a ragtag Birmingham City side who the whole of their team cost less than one of your players. How do you feel?
It makes you feel quite a bit despondent, because it looks like it's a 12-month syndrome. The same thing happened last season with McLaren and the last 13 games.
I've got to give Rockin Jonny a little bit of credit, actually. Here's a guy that, only goes back to the pub when Derby lose. If Derby win, he won't go to the pub afterwards and gloat. Yeah, I'm going to go and let everybody out, have a pop at him if Derby lose. That's quite clever. Nice one.
But what I must say, in Derby itself after the game, we met some Blues fans in the Brunswick. Mm. The thing is, got back to the Brunswick, and they relaunched my beer on the day. So all these Blues fans are necking my beer. You know, and that's fantastic.
Ironic.
And I've that's what I've it's all
say,
about, though, isn't it?
I've got to say hello to June, Barbara, Fred and Ted.
And anybody else that knows
And everybody
me.
Else. Oh, and big, and big Kevin, you talked for doing all my stats for me other show.
Cracking stuff. All right, tonight we are playing once again What's in the Box. Chris Pugh has bought something in, and we want to know what's in the box. It's the same box as it was a couple of weeks ago, which it looks like Mars bars, but it's not. There's something in the box that I don't know about. Chris, do you know about?
I'm going to
And Rockin Jonny, do you know? No, because he went outside to his car and put whatever's in the box.
Two items.
In the, so there's two in items the in the box.
Yeah.
Right, so now what we're going to do is...
It's not for a dead ram.
Is, yeah. It's not a dead ram, no.
It's horns, isn't it? We've now got to work, we've now got to disseminate. We've got just an hour and 15 minutes now then to find out what's in the box. So we're going to shorten the time down. We're not actually going to start the what's in the box until a quarter to on a night time. So what's in the box? Is that is it the flag from the team photo? No, that's my personal flag.
Is that your
that's
flag?
My, that flag that is in the team photo was the very last flag to be lowered on Derby County's old stadium before they brought it down. There you go.
The baseball ground.
The baseball ground. That is the actual flag from the baseball ground. My mate, the builder, Andy Lane, went up there to start taking some stuff out. One of the first things he did.
3-1 the last match.
He took that flag down, and that's in my possession. So there you go. That's the history of the flag. Is it a knife and fork?
It's not.
It's not a knife and fork.
Is it catering related?
It's not.
Oh, I feel like that was one of the questions I was going to ask. It's a brilliant question.
It is football related.
It's football related. Two things in the box. Two things in the box. It's football related.
It can't be a Derby pie.
Yeah, Derby pie.
There was none left.
There wasn't
any. I don't know. Well done, George.
I don't know what one looks like.
You should have got that. You should have got that at half past to buy one, shouldn't you?
Yeah, he's the one you could have had.
Yeah.
It's a photo.
It's not a photo.
Not
no.
a photo.
Okay, so there you go. It's what's in the box. It is not catering related. It is football related.
You didn't get the referee's whistle on Saturday.
I didn't, know.
No.
No, sorry.
Right, I'm sure we'll come back to that amazing game throughout the course of the programme, but there's another thing that I want to read out as well is something that came up on Facebook the other day, and it was a message from a Derby fan written onto the Blues page. I'm a Derby fan and was sat right by the Birmingham fans. Credit where it is due. They sang from minute one to the end, as you can tell by my voice, and have been the better away supporters we've had at the iPro so far this season. Deserved the win. Derby were so very poor that I left after the third goal, and I never leave a game early from a Derby fan. This keep right on. That was a nice message.
Yeah,
and, I'm sure he saw it. He had lots of nice messages back as well.
Yeah, yeah, 3,000 Blues fans. You know, I think Derby away is renowned as a great well there, day
yeah.
out. So
yeah,
you know, when you get 3,000 going and the game goes in that manner.
There was a gentleman on the Davo video. You need to download that and have a look at Davo's fans video on YouTube. Excellent. I watched it this afternoon, and there's a gentleman on there who interviewed, and he said the Fulham game's always a brilliant game. This beat it hands down.
Yeah, that
was nice. I think nice. You know, it's nice when opposing supporters give you know a little bit of credit for because our support was just out of this world. That was how I want it every single week. I'm not going to get it at St Andrews, aren't we? We're not going to get it at St Andrews.
Great to hear the Derby fans complimenting the Blues. Faithful, keep right on. Hayden from last week. He was our guest last week.
Thanks, Hayden. Sorry I didn't get the opportunity to meet you last week, buddy, but I did have brake problems. £289. £289, Chris. To have my 289 quid.
Incredible.
Yeah, mate.
Bye bye.
By the way,
I am not riding a push bike up the M42 to come here on a Monday night.
by the way, Hayden's got a show coming up shortly as well on SRB.
On SRB, cracking, brilliant. Yes, okay, does anybody know where I can get the DVD of the form match? I'm sure you'll have to contact the club for that due to copyright reasons.
There must be one.
So there probably is one.
There will be one. There's someone I'll have high on. I'd like to say the goal as well, a mention for Clifton Bell's goal. For me, as somebody who's been home and away for so many years watching Blues, that is up there with Jerome's yep. away at Liverpool mm-hmm. as one of the best goals I've seen live. You know, as you see it drop into him, that has hung in the air for so long. You know, and he could have eased, that could have gone anywhere, but you know, he's connected with it so well and kept it down, and you know, it struck him with such force. It's an absolutely beautiful strike.
Chris Brown's got a walking stick. He has a little bit of a bad back at the moment.
Not well.
Blue Obber says we all stayed long after the final whistle, and rightfully so, because I think, you know what. And it was great to see Gary Rowett come, you know, to me personally, right, I'd like to see the whole team on a day like that come right up to you, man, because it takes them a few seconds, yeah?
Yeah.
It takes them a few seconds. It's not I'd like to have seen the whole team come and thank each one of them supporters, because what we gave was, they talk about the 12th man and all this, right, but we gave more than that, man. We gave everything we could. Every sinew of our vocal cords was destroyed from start to finish. Mine still are. I don't know if I'm ever going to get over this. My career may be over.
Good play.
What's in the box, lovely? Is it Birmingham City related?
Yes.
Yes, it is. So there you go. We're narrowing it down. We're getting him. Yeah. Is it the amount of Mars bars in weight that Mr. Pugh has lost? Brilliant.
I'll have to work that out. Probably not, though.
Probably not. No.
I'd imagine I've lost a bit more.
Oh, dear.
This is shirt.
Georgie Blue says he agrees. He says it's on par with Gardner's goal at West Ham as well.
Gardner's at West Ham?
Let the look of that, yeah. Agree. On a par with Gardner's against West Ham. In the cup final.
At home to West Ham.
It was on par with Charlie George's against Real Madrid, 1975.
I'd have to YouTube that one.
But scored two.
Yeah,
we'd have to YouTube that as well, because we don't have memories like that. He's like a savant. Our own little savant in the corner here.
But I mean, just
shirt.
One of the items is a shirt.
Yeah.
Oh. So one of the items is a shirt.
It is.
Is it a signed shirt?
It is a signed shirt.
Is it Karen Carney's signed shirt?
No.
There you go. Right, Karen's been in the news today.
Yeah, so I hear
England's winning,
doing something with Paul Robinson. Chris,
yeah, I think they were going around schools talking regarding fitness and that, like in classroom.
Oh, okay. Locally.
Yep.
Yeah.
Any news from the ladies' camp?
No.
Quiet. And was it just Nick singing? The rest of you sound fine. I wasn't just singing. I gave it everything I possibly had, mate. Because I tell you what, I'm just so happy.
I
have had the happiest weekend I've had for God knows how long, mate.
I've done nothing but work all weekend. When you're standing, obviously you're standing the whole way through. So you start the game standing with the three people to the left of me, which was one of you, and then the second half started, and Nick had disappeared, but there was like four other people
there. Yes, I know,
you know, it's
there was a
white guy.
People standing in the aisles, wasn't there?
Yeah,
seats.
Again, have a look on Damo's video after the third goal. There's a lad running around with another lad on his shoulders, and the steward's trying to get him down. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's just funny. It's only fun, you know.
Everyone wants to go towards the back anyway for a white game.
And I don't like strep sores, by the way, George Blue, so sorry about that, mate. You're just going to have to suffer it tonight. Two things in the box. We've got the fact that it's a shirt, a signed shirt. Have we actually got to get who has signed it then?
Anywhere close.
So it's going to be your era.
Is in the team now?
Second, sorry.
Is in the team now?
What time?
The shirt, is it?
Is it a current Birmingham player?
In the team now.
There is a signature on the shirt that is a player for Blues right at the moment.
So it's a process of elimination then, isn't it?
So we just need to go through them, I tell you.
John Terrell then?
No.
Oh dear, Blue Obber says Nick wasn't just singing, he was drinking too, and sat in the aisle all the way up. I sat in the aisle of the bus. And he comes having conversation with people. Like.
Come sat next to me, I didn't have a clue, he was just mumbling random nonsense. No.
Oh, I did pay your beer tab, by the way.
I don't get out much, just tell me how much it is, Chris.
40-something.
I don't care. Is it a grey signed shirt? No, because he's no longer a Birmingham City player. And did we miss him, by the way, the weekend? There's a thought, isn't it?
No, not at all. I mean, Davis played out on the right.
We bought Davis on,
if we were going to if we were going to define specific positions, Davis was the one who was playing of the right. Of, you know, Gleeson and Keefton Bell were holding, and then Davis was over on the right. But a lot of the time he was in helping the other two. Mm. But when we broke forward, it was Davis who was pushing out to the right. So in that sense, possibly we could, like I said at the start, if we would have had a more attacking player in that position, you know, we could have caused them even more problems, especially in the second half. But would we have got to that point where at 0-0 at half time and we're looking comfortable if we wouldn't have had Davis in with Gleeson and Keefton Bald, you know, protecting the defence and everything? I think the way we set up, you know, was perfect really. And all right, Davis, not the quickest and not the most gifted going forward, but he certainly did a job for us, as did every one of them.
George says, is it a Paul Robinson signed shirt?
It is not.
It is not. No. And the ELO says, I've still got the driver, I should think, that is chasing me for Nick's bar bill. Who's ELO?
Dennis
the Menace. All right, okay. I'll catch a weirdo, don't worry.
Yeah.
I'll catch a weirdo.
At some point, you'll pay up.
I'll pay up. Oh, dear. Is it Solomon Ottebor?
No.
Okay, all right. So we also have something else that's in the box as well. There are two items in the box. We've got one.
Is the other thing a programme?
Is it Gary Rowett? No, because it's a player.
Yes, it's a programme, the other one.
I've got both. Shirt and a programme.
Rockin Jonny's Dignity after Saturday.
I'm not bringing him again.
No, it's not Rockin Jonny's Dignity after Saturday. No. That's long gone.
Thanks.
Hobber says Caddis was solid too. Is it a Caddis signed shirt?
It's not a Caddis signed shirt, but I'd agree with Hobber there. Yeah, absolutely. He was excellent.
Well, there wasn't one player that you can single out as not giving it, you know, not giving everything.
But
you know,
Keith and Bulls signed shirt.
No, I wish it was. You know, the Derby team on paper up against our team, individually, they should have the edge over every one of us. But every one of our players, with the exception of maybe Grounds at times in the first half against Ince. You know,
Ince is good, though, isn't he?
Ince is a quality player, but it was only at times where I thought Ince had got the better of Grounds. But second half, certainly, and you know, up to the point he went off, he didn't do anything. You know, Grounds had the better of him. And then when he went off, Grounds had an easy time of it on the left. But yeah, I think individually, every one of our players won their individual battles against their opposite number. Which when that happens, is perfect to say, really.
So it's Saturday's programme and a signed shirt?
It's not Saturday's programme.
It's not Saturday's.
Okay, is it a Kuzak shirt?
No.
Okay, George Blue said, he said programme. Can we have a look back on the shout box, Chris, in previous sentences to say if that's there, then we're going to credit George with that. We can't see anything at the minute.
There you go.
Program from the game.
Would have been no.
Sorry, can't have that then. So Rockin Jonny has got it at the moment. Okay, so we need to find out who this signature is from. We've got just about an hour to do.
Is it the one that's just come on loan from Sunderland?
No, it's not Will Buckley, no.
We need to come through the team, haven't we?
You have, Neil, eh?
Yeah. Super 6, should we just skip that?
No.
All right.
I missed one, didn't I?
Did you miss it? I got two points.
I got it's not Gleeson.
Two points, and I saw that you got none, and I thought, I wonder if he's done it or not. Is there any way on Super 6 you can check it, you know, whether they actually have partaken?
I don't think so.
No. I had just a quick you've fiddle around with it the other day to see what...
I'm still about far behind. I think I'm only about 6 or 7 points behind you, so...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I got 8.
You got 8.
Yeah, which was much needed because I've...
You'd slipped down the ranks a bit.
Slipped down the ranks a bit. Yeah.
Is it a Morrison shirt?
It's not a Morrison shirt. No.
Okay, can I ask another question then? Is it a player from the first full team? From the first full team, not somebody that's just on Blues books?
From Birmingham City's first full team.
No. Right. Yeah, that's wiped the smirk off your face, hasn't it? So it is not a regular first team player.
I'm amazed people haven't asked the obvious question. as it's my turn to bring something in. That's all I'll say.
Hey?
Is it David Davis's?
No, it's not a first team player. We've just established. No, it's not a first team player.
Oh, we don't know any of the others, do we?
What do you mean? Is it signed by your catering manager?
No. He didn't play Saturday.
No. For selling extra burgers.
He didn't play Saturday. No.
For making sure the burgers are well stocked in the way end.
Yeah. Especially in the away end, yeah.
Anybody from the ladies?
Yes.
Ah, there you go, Channel K.
So it's a ladies' shirt.
Yes.
With ladies' shirt.
And it's a programme from the ladies. So I take it these were presented to you at a game?
No. The program was brought to me. The shirt was presented to
Alex Jones.
It's an England program then in Canada, is it an England program in Canada?
It's not. No.
Is it a Birmingham City program?
It's a Birmingham City program.
A Birmingham City ladies program.
Yes.
There you go. That's all the clues I'm going to give you. It's obviously not shinny because we've just found out it's a woman.
Well, she's had some amazing transformation the last 2 weeks.
And we've also established earlier, Blue Hopper, that it isn't a Karen Carney. It's not a Karen Carney signed shirt.
It's not.
Potter?
No.
Oh, I thought I was just going to throw an extra one in. You know what I mean? Just throw an extra
I bet
one.
You can't think of another one.
Well, not Jade.
Moore?
No.
No. But you can't think of
there you go.
But you can't think of another one.
No, you think of one.
I can't. I can't.
Cue everybody googling Blues Ladies. Oh, yes.
No, Harry, it's not Carney. And ELO says it must have been a freebie.
It must have been a freebie.
What was the freebie?
Yeah, it.
Anything.
It.
The shirt, maybe. The programme, because you wouldn't buy a programme, would you? You wouldn't normally buy a programme.
I bought the programme. Mm. And the shirt was presented to me.
Are they signed by the same person?
No.
Somebody's Googling.
Emily Westwood. Here we go.
It's not Emily Westwood.
Oh, brilliant, brilliant, brilliant.
I got a feeling the shirt might be going in a minute.
Yeah, well. Yeah. There can't be many left.
Depending on people's broadband speeds.
Yeah.
Yes, the shirt is signed by...
As you can see, I'm not on Google. Look, no, I've still got my program notes on the iPad, so I wouldn't
You can always tell when we're on Google, because there's a long pause now. Until the next go.
Yeah.
Everyone's going through.
There we go.
Jade Moore. No, we've done Jade Moore, not Jade. Docco's not on tonight by the look of it. He would certainly be Googling
the
anyway.
King of the Google.
King of the cheats, Docco. King of the cheats, Docco.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Super 6 didn't go down very well for me this weekend. 2 points, I really don't, you know, I looked at it and... When I got back and Sharon said to me, she's only got 2 points on Super 6 this week. I was like, you know, I actually don't care.
Well, I'll tell you what, it was, considering one of them was Bristol City Middlesbrough, and Middlesbrough lost at Bristol City, I doubt hardly anybody would have predicted that scoreline.
Swansea playing, Kirsty Linnett?
It's not
Kirsty Linnett. And was it the FA Cup final game?
What's this?
The programme.
The ladies' FA.
I will give you that.
Oh, well done.
I'll show you that.
Brilliant.
Okay, well done, Harry. BCFC 98.
It's nice programme from the FA.
Sophie Bagley?
No.
Okay, all right. It's all about Swansea tonight. Swansea currently 0-0 with Watford. Obviously, we're looking for a Swansea win there just to keep the pressure on.
And in the FA Cup third round first fixture, which was postponed originally, which is being played tonight, it's Newport County 1, Blackburn 1, but Blackburn are down to 10 men.
Already?
So, and that's coming up to half-time. That was an early kick-off. No, Mark Byrne scored for Newport. Ben Marshall put Blackburn ahead.
Oh, Stoke
Region. Yes. Yes, he is, isn't he?
Okay, going back to the Derby game, then, can I just say how well Robbo took that goal as well? From the corner from a goal that flicked on.
Yeah,
by,
he read it beautifully,
bang,
didn't he?
Straight in the back of the net.
He could have overdid his run. But yeah, he timed it beautifully and it just fell perfectly
to him.
I think
I fell on the floor at that point. I was underneath like lots of people.
I don't think it's the first time.
I think that was alcohol related.
Outside the Black Swan as we got off the coach. Saw that one.
I don't get out much, mate.
He did well for a 37-year-old, yes.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
He did, you know.
I thought you were about me. No. Keep it on your feet.
defensively as well, up against a quick young striker in Nick Blackman, and then when Chris Martin come on as well,
he
and Morrison did a really good job nullifying any of the threat from the Derby strikers. So it was one of his better games.
In his favour, Blackman didn't get any service.
No, I'd agree with that. Yeah, he was trying to make runs.
And Kamara, when he started making his runs, he didn't get any service.
No.
It was strangers, and they just met up on the day, to be honest.
Yeah. Mm. I mean, when did Kamara come? Blackman's been signed a week.
Yeah.
Week and a bit, was it?
Yeah.
And then Kamara this week. So they haven't had a lot of time with the team. Maybe it would have been more beneficial with them to start with the likes of Martin and Butterfield rather than bring the new players in. But I'm not going to...
Is it Mannion?
It's Aoife Mannion.
Aoife Mannion?
Yes.
It's Aoife Mannion. Blue Harbour strikes again, right at the heart of the very crisp view. Aoife Mannion. Well done, Blue Harbour.
I'll show you them.
Well done.
I'll get half-time and I'll show
you. Yeah, we'll get photographs up. All right, coming up to half-time, Chris, what music have we got lined up today?
Can I just say, for that competition, you get absolutely
nothing. Only the fact and the knowledge. Just the fact and the knowledge that they got yours the quickest out of all of us.
Yeah,
so...
And I had two items as well.
Yeah.
Do you feel done, do you?
Yeah.
Bless you. All right, then, after the half-time break, we'll be having a chat with Rockin Jonny about his beer. We're going to be looking at the Hall game, Scarf Lady, the prices for the Hall game, the competition, of course... probably loads more talk about the game, so we'll see you in 3 or 4 minutes.
We are the lads from the Tilton. We'll support you till the end of the day. We're so happy following the Blues. We love you, what more can we say? Down at St Andrews, we are all supporters of our team. We chant the Super Blues, bring it all around.
Well, I'm up on the 11th floor and I'm watching the cruisers below. In the basement, my weekend's at an all-time low. Well, he's down on the street and he's trying hard to pull his sister Flo. As she's hoping to score, well, I can't see her letting him go. Look out of her heart, look out of her mind. Oh, no, no, she's so swiftly in her saddle and tie. In her barcode and bibbidi-bobbidi hat. Oh, but I could do better than that. She's an old-time ambassador of sea-talking, night-walking games. And she's known in the dark as clubs for pushing ahead of the days. If she says she can do it, then she can do it. She don't make false claims. But she's a queen, such a queen, such a laughter is stuck in their brains. Now she's leading him on, and she'll lay it right down. Now she's leading him on, and she'll lay it right down. Well, it could have been me, yes, it could have been me. What did I say? What did I say? So cold that it don't feel like no bed at all. Yes, I lay down a while and I gaze on my hotel wall. Oh, it's down on the street, so I throw both his bags down the hall. And I'm phoning a cab, cause my stomach feels small. There's a taste.
Welcome back to the Tilton Talk Show. I'm trying my best with my voice with myself, Chris Pugh, Chris Brown, and the inimitable Mr. Rockin Jonny, our adopted Derby fan. First thing I want to talk about is we want to ask you lovely people out there. Obviously, Gary Rowett is the manager of Birmingham City Football Club, but he also played for Derby County. We want as many players that have played for both teams as possible in 45 minutes, please. So that's as many players that have played for both Derby and Birmingham City in the next 45 minutes. Away you go.
And there's quite a few.
There is quite a few, because we've been chatting about them in the half-time break.
We got some.
ELO, where and when is the next Tilton Tour trip? Personally, I'd like Rotherham, but...
Is that a bit too soon?
Is it a bit too soon?
Too soon, probably. Yeah. Well, it's somewhere nice to go. Yeah, is Rotherham exactly. nice?
It's north, isn't it?
It's no, horrible, isn't it?
Is it?
Horrible Rotherham is.
Oh yeah, it's one of your worst grounds you've ever been
to.
Isn't it?
Well, I didn't. I haven't been to the new one, but I went to Millmore, and it was absolutely vile. Yeah.
Okay, they're coming in. We've got two, Gemmell and Michael Johnson. Could we just keep a tingy tally, a five-chart tally of how many we get, Chris, if you could?
Yeah, right.
So that's two. The first two, Archie Gemmell and Michael Johnson. Keep them coming. Gary Rowett obviously isn't included because he was mentioned in the opening statement. What's in the box next week will be done by my good self. So we've all failed so far. We've failed with the Scotch egg. We've failed with the football programme and the shirt. And we certainly failed with whatever you put in yours. What was it, Connor?
I can't remember now. It's very memorable, obviously.
Yeah, not that many. Queen's Park Rangers away, perhaps suggested as the next away day.
Could be.
Distance.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll have some thoughts on that, and then see what we can get organised and sorted.
Still got Wolves to come away.
Yeah, that's one I definitely want to do. Definitely want to do.
It's not much of a trip, though, is it?
It's near my son's birthday. I think that one.
No,
so
that's true. Yeah.
It's only a couple of bus stops.
I'll pay for his ticket for that one once I've paid my bar bill.
You have nothing left after the bar bill.
Bristol City.
That's all right. That would be a nice one. Yeah. Nice one. Okay. Birmingham City versus Ipswich this Saturday. You've probably all seen it because it's been all over the Book of Face and Twitter and everywhere. Is that our wonderful, 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 iconic scarf lady is going to be leading the team out on that momentous day for her. It's going to be an absolutely beautiful day for her, bless her. I certainly know that I remember seeing her back in 1972 at the first ever game I went to. And I know that probably many, if not all of you, have bumped into her at some junction. And what would be lovely, as Chris Pugh suggested before we kicked in tonight, is that everybody take a scarf and hold it up when she comes out. That would be absolutely
brilliant.
That's
the same as a
walk-on. Wasn't my suggestion. It was Chris Pugh's suggestion, but I think it is a brilliant suggestion. All take a scarf. Take 10 scarves. Put 30 scarves on your arms. Let's all go dressed as a scarf lady. Let's do it proper. We're Birmingham City. We'll dress how we want. But it'd be lovely if you know, when she did come out. And what you've also got to do, though, is get there early, because the teams come out and then, you know, still 5 minutes after time, people are still walking in. That annoys me. Yeah. That annoys me as much as people.
I mean, it'd be nice if the Tilton could, you know, if there was sort of a mosaic where, you know, the whole of even if it's just the upper Tilton, because we know that the lower doesn't really sell out that well.
Yeah.
But, you know, if the upper Tilton could all lift a scarf, I think that'd be a pretty good one.
What would be even better is if they had, you know, them squares that they do at Wembley with the flags, if you could do it and there's a photograph of her, a picture of her, or something like that. I don't know, Hollywood Monster, perhaps.
You've only got like 4 days to get that sorted.
Yeah, yeah.
So it'd be nice to see scarves at every game, to be honest.
Pushing it a bit, isn't it?
Just that. A game of two scarves.
Oh, who brought him?
Pesky Salido.
Pesky Salido, well done. Did Phil Gee pay for both?
Phil Gee, Phil G, isn't it?
Phil G.
Phil G, yeah, he played for both, didn't he?
Yes.
Yeah.
But yeah, cracking accolade for her, because she's been going there years. She's, you know, in the 70s now, so she's obviously a little bit frailer.
Yeah.
But I think it's just brilliant of the club to sort of lift up, because I know that we had that issue here a couple of years ago where that dirty Villa fan wrote on that she'd passed away. And that
we did the tribute to her, didn't we?
That upset me. That really upset me, because there's no need for that. It's just vile. That's horrible.
I think she was upset about it as well.
And the club did loads. They popped round and saw her and did everything, you know, which I think
that's great. Yeah,
she didn't have to do, but it was very nice of them to do that. But for them to allow her to walk the team out against Ipswich on Saturday, it's going to be an iconic moment. There you go. Have you got an iconic person at Derby apart from your good self, Rockin?
Well, we used to have Badgeman.
Badgeman, I remember that.
And he died about 2 years ago.
Because I used to have a shirt like this, and it was just covered in badges back in the...
I think we've got a Badgeman down the Blues as well. I've seen a bloke who's covered in badges down.
When we played Wolves away 2 seasons ago, the Wolves did a tribute to Badgeman. They did a big picture of him in the programme.
That's good.
Yeah. Very nice.
Brilliant stuff.
Very nice. My idea, Birmingham Scarf Day.
There you go. He's pinched it off.
Just stole my heart.
Is he jumping on the bandwagon?
I think he is, yeah.
The Tilton Talk bandwagon.
Ring of fire.
There's a habit of that,
yeah. Right, so come on then, as many Derby and Birmingham City players as you can. I think Bristol City might be a good idea, but Wolves certainly, if we could do one for that
Bristol
one
City's
as well.
Next week, so
it's probably too soon.
Wolves,
second of April is Charlton away.
That's
a proper old school ground.
Charlton have all got that whole stand behind the goal,
yeah.
So we'll probably get loads of tickets for that. So that could be a possibility.
But the Wolves one sounds good as well.
Yeah,
but then of course
you could always
Charlton, yeah, that's true.
Yeah. It is, yeah.
Big of a place.
Got to go to Cannon Street, yeah. And then walk down Floyd Road.
Yeah. Channel K says, Badge Man down the blues is called Kenny, has a long scarf covered in badges. There we go. I think I've probably bought a few off him in the past, to be honest with you. We've got a bruise man. I see many blokes covered in bruises down the blues.
Yeah, Capo's usually got one on the back of his head, doesn't he? Yeah.
I wasn't quite with what he was trying to say there. For a bruise. How about Huddersfield away Saturday 23rd April? That sounds a good one as well.
Is that the last home away game of the season?
Oh, come on, we've got to do the last
home. Like, yeah,
we've got to do the last.
No, we ain't.
Why?
Cardiff. I've vowed never go back to Cardiff.
Why? Why have you vowed never?
Horrible.
Well, we know that, but why?
Saturday the 9th of April, Reading.
Magic Johnson, of course.
Michael Johnson.
I posted a picture last week around the Blues player pages saying Birmingham's scarf David Carroll in the bottom hand corner. There you go. So it was his idea.
Okay. Right, well, okay. Do you know something? We're a team. Yeah. We don't do my idea.
It's our idea.
It's an idea.
It's the team's idea. It's the team's
idea.
And
all that matters is that we celebrate that lady going to the Blues.
Of course.
Ever since. And actually, always nice to see her there, though.
Yeah.
Martin Call, did he run out for Blues?
Martin Call?
Don't know.
Yes.
Did he?
For Birmingham as well.
Oh, right. He played for Birmingham.
Yes, he did. Yeah.
And Derby. Yeah. Definitely.
There's one play for Forest, Derby and Blues. Okay. One player.
Okay, that's brilliant. Now I want to go on and just have a quick chat about the Hull game, the impending Hull game that was scheduled, I think, for the 6th of March. That's now been brought forward by Sky to Thursday.
Just want to put in Swansea 0, Watford 0.
Swansea 0, Watford 0, latest update, okay. That was been brought forward now to the Thursday night. Must pay absolute respect and credit to Blues because the prices are now down to a tenner, pound for kids. I'll tell you what we should do. You know what we should do, right? I'll give Channel K this idea, because I don't mind, because we're a team. Do you know what we should do? We should turn up in force to say to Sky TV, you ain't wrecking our game. Because to move it to a Thursday night, and if the Blues had kept it at £20 a ticket, there'd have been 12, 13,000 there,
probably,
perhaps.
Yeah.
You know, what we should do, we should turn up in absolute force, as many of us as possibly can scrape yourselves down Thursday night.
Thursday night.
It's a tenner a ticket, though,
It's a Thursday night.
And kids are at school the next morning. I know, it's difficult. It's difficult. And Sky TV have destroyed the game, to be perfectly honest with you.
Yeah.
An obvious one, Colin Todd. Yes, absolutely. Yeah, completely. We got him as well in the half-time. Channel K says he was joking. No, I've took it to heart now.
No.
And I
still you've upset him now.
I still haven't got my Alpari badge on the bracelet.
Stuff here, he says. Yeah. No, I agree. I think it would be great to see Blues rocking with £28,000 fans on Thursday night. But I can't understand.
Horwee, I like that name.
Horwee.
Horwee. Oh, who are we? Sorry.
Yeah. Who are we? we know, it doesn't look like Horwee.
The playoffs or the semi-final and final for Tilton Tours. That's got to be. It's got to be. You've got us all excited now. You've made everybody smile.
Pushing it out.
Yes, you're spot on with Hall.
I've
got a feeling I know who that is.
You wouldn't get, right, okay, there you go. There's a question for you then. Would you want to play Birmingham City in the playoff final at Wembley?
No.
Not really. No.
Because it's an away day for us, isn't
it? Like I said, that result has made the Championship teams, you know, stand up and notice Blues now. Mm. And I don't think, you know, when you can see what we can do away from home, go to Derby and win 3-0. I don't think if you know, on the off chance we do sneak into the playoffs, I don't think any team would want to face us.
No.
But every club has a blip as well, don't they?
Oh yeah, absolutely. And ours will come.
Well, we had ours when we lost the Don for a few weeks, didn't we? Really?
Yeah.
So let that be ours. Let that be.
Yeah, it might well be ours.
George Blue says Jonathan Hunt, but not 100% sure, might be getting mixed up with another Hunt. Jonathan Hunt. Well, if Rockin Jonny says it is because he's our resident savant.
Barcelona player.
Oh dear, Harry seems to think there'll be about 19,000 there for Hull.
I think that. I think we'll struggle to get 20, but...
Do you think?
Yeah, I think we'll okay. Yeah.
All right. Well,
Hull won't bring...
It's a long way
to... Because you'll still get the people who think, well, it's on Sky.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
Cold.
Yeah.
School night.
School night is the issue. It's the biggest issue.
Sky, is it?
Got to go work in
the morning. Yeah, that's why they've moved it to the Thursday, because it's a Sky game. So.
We've got United in the Cup Friday night.
Are you bragging?
Friday night.
Are you bragging that you've got United in the Cup?
No, because we'll beat them.
You're going to beat them? Well, then predict your score.
2-0 Derby.
Either 2-0 Derby or 2-1. Yeah.
Mind you, the whole game's on the 3rd of March.
3rd of March.
So there are...
That's right, yeah.
5-6 fixtures before that. So depending on how we do in those games...
Ah, it could be absolutely
If we're unbeaten in the six games leading up to that whole game...
And how beautiful would it be?
There might be a few there.
Yeah.
How beautiful it would be if they moved the Villa game to that Thursday night as well, and that's the day they got relegated. Fat lady's not seen yet.
No.
Oh dear.
Chris is hanging on to that thread.
She won't
thread.
Be singing, aren't you?
You're still hanging on to that thread.
Mike. Who's Mike? Lollop Mike. Lollop never mind,
Mike.
Don't know.
Mike.
All right. Lollop
Mike. I think we're talking about Johnny. Sounds like Mike, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Johnny. Mike.
Yeah.
Mike.
Yeah.
Says,
he's stalking into a mic. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I suppose he's got it. I suppose he's got
it. Your brother says Charlton would be good for the OI, Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Get the bus back.
It's just the pure fact that it's such a horrible South place to London, get to. Yeah.
It's terrible.
Horrible.
Mike Langan. Mike or Dave Langan. Which of the Langan brothers played?
Dave Langan.
Dave Langan. There you go. We'll give you that, George Blue. Well done.
Yeah.
Well done.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great player. Great player, Dave Langan.
I think Mike Langan or Dave did. I can't remember his first name.
It's Dave Langan.
Brilliant.
In truth, we should be hitting 20,000, in my opinion. Fantastic from the club to put the price down to £10. People should remember the stubs from previous tickets for the playoffs. I suppose that...
Everyone's getting carried away, aren't they after that now?
Yeah, we have a good win. Calm down, everybody, calm down.
That P word's getting more and more frequent on the show.
We have to look at it in reality. We're still at 8th at the minute, and that's where we be. That's where we reside. We are outside of the playoffs, so let's not get carried away.
Two wins in the mix.
I did predict that there'd be 7th. I think yours was 10th, was it?
10th to 12th, I think.
10th to 12th,
I think it was
13th. 13th, you black sheep of the family, you are, Chris. You know that.
Plenty of time.
You can join the Rams if you're a black sheep.
A little play on words there. Did you get it?
Clever.
I am struggling tonight, Chris.
You can join the Rams.
I am struggling tonight.
Struggling.
Okay, rocking then. So, what have you been up to since you were last in studio? Which was how long ago?
Yes, we've been doing a bit of fundraising again.
Yeah.
Did a 20-mile walk for the Utoxeter youth team.
Right.
And we're doing another one. We're doing it in April or May, and we're also doing it for autism as well. And so I'm not even going to start without this £200 raised. I'm not going to even start because of insurance cover and all that they have to take out now.
Oh, you are joking.
And you have to walk around a playing field.
You have to have insurance to do a sponsored walk.
You can't go to a stadium.
Of course,
and
you
do it.
What is the world coming to?
Health and safety.
What is the world coming to?
It's ridiculous.
God, blimey.
Yeah.
Mad. That is mad.
Yeah.
That is mad. Competition then, Chris.
Competition?
For this week.
I'll get the shirt.
That'll be up and ready.
I've got one printed and ready, so we'll get it ready for Friday.
Brilliant.
Yeah, no problem.
So goal alert.
Goal alert.
Don't start on that radio station, mate. Right.
Copyright that is.
Okay.
It's Swansea City 1, Watford.
Yes! Get in! Yes! Yes! Yes!
Ashley Williams.
Well done, Ash. Steve Lynx and Kevin Poole.
Kevin Poole? Didn't know he
did. Yes, Kevin Poole, definitely.
Steve Lynx, I think, did as
Stevie
well.
Linux,
yeah,
well,
possibly. But definitely Kevin Poole.
Yeah.
Because he played when he was 40.
I used to love that goal.
That's
alert.
Right, he did, yeah. Because he come to us and he was getting on a bit.
And then
he went
to Burton after that.
He was with us for a long time as well.
Yeah.
Rockin', we was on the way out in here today and we listened to that hour-long programme called Radio Aston. Blues got a mention at the very start where they play all the goals for the week. And how many Birmingham City supporters were on that show tonight?
None.
Oh.
Nobody rang in.
An emphatic win like
right,
that.
Right, okay.
An emphatic win like that, and they don't get one Blues fan on.
This is why, of what we're doing.
This is why we do what we do, for whom we do crazy. It for. That is mad, isn't it? Yeah. You know, it was all. It was just literally all talking about a 1-1 draw. Who cares? Who cares about a 1-1 draw? Because that 1-1 draw at the moment means nothing. It means you're another 2 points behind. Oh. And it looks good.
They're still going to escape,
owes another £5 to get the Villa.
Oh, I thought you said you were going to say B6.
Relegation fund.
When we talk about relegation, we don't know. Oh, so it's just so that everybody knows where they are.
B6. You're getting some people on loan from B6.
How are you going to
say about that?
God, then Mr. Pugh owes another £5 to get the what? The relegation fund, as he said he would.
On the coach back from Derby, I made the bold claim that the Blues goals wouldn't be shown before 9:30 on the Channel 5 highlights show.
Right.
And a £5 charity bet was placed.
Well done.
I have lost that bet.
Okay. You're on at 10 past.
They were on about 4:15. Yeah. Yeah. So
is that going into the Just Giving page?
The link is on the page. The link is on the page. I told you to the page.
Yeah. Okay. SKC.
Thanks for reminding everybody. Yes. Dennis.
I've written it down.
What time was the Blues on Channel 5 on Friday,
yes,
Chris?
Thank you, Hopper. That was about 9:15.
I still don't watch it, to be honest.
Here's the truth. I watched it on Plus 24 because it's on the day after, isn't it? No. Only because I wanted to watch the Blues goals.
Yeah.
And they've changed the format considerably. They've changed a lot on it.
Yeah.
But it's just still
naff.
It's the next Blues player on it, though.
Well, there was Michael Gray and Clinton Morrison, and they asked the question, will Blues make the playoffs? And both of them said yes.
Did they?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a bit of a
bold statement at this stage. Bold statement still. I mean, look, of course we want them to. Of course we want them to. But it's just too early, isn't it?
It's too early. The next two home games are Ipswich and Sheffield Wednesday.
Ipswich is going to be a hard
Ipswich and Sheffield Wednesday, who are the two teams above us at the moment.
They'll be both hard games.
Now, if we manage to win both of them, then even a pessimist like me says we have to be considered as a great shout for playoffs. But obviously, those two games are going to be really tough. Ipswich on Saturday and then Sheffield Wednesday in a couple of weeks. You know, they are really tough games. But if we can manage to beat them, if we beat Ipswich on Saturday, then we leapfrog them for
And
then obviously Sheffield Wednesday is coming up as well.
Derby's on the way down.
We've got Bristol City away, which, they beat Middlesbrough at the weekend, but they're not doing too well at the moment.
Wouldn't have put that down, would you, though?
No, not at all. No,
definitely not. No.
But there's a chance now for Blues to take the confidence from that Derby win, which must be sky high. After a win like that,
can you imagine their bus back?
Well, exactly. Yeah.
Exactly. But everybody was just
that dressing room must have been sky high. And if we can take that into the Ipswich game, then we've got a really good chance to lay a marker now and to put our foot down and let the Championship know that we're really in this race for the playoffs.
George Blue says that Derby result might not have done us any favours. I can imagine Gary Rowett saying no, I said 1-0.
Well, cracking. Every other Championship team now is going to be looking at us thinking, as I said before, that's a real standout result for the weekend, and it's going to have a few teams looking at us and worrying.
Especially when we go away.
Yeah, exactly. The capabilities of what we've got when we do go away, hitting teams, when we're clinical like that, and we can be tight. We know we're hard to beat. But when we're clinical like that as well, it's a really good sign for the rest of the season.
And what must have been about like in your dressing room then?
Oh dear, must have been like a morgue. It must have been. I bet nobody even spoke or looked at anybody or anything. I I bet.
But I wonder what your chairman's reaction was as well after that. You know, because he's obviously upset the boat there, hasn't he? Yeah, and he's gone and upset the boat, and then you've literally been turned over by, like I say, a ragtag team. And that's, we know what we are, don't we, Chris? We do know what we are.
Yeah.
But we also know that that team is a team that sticks together. It's solid. Right, it's all for one for all.
We've got to be,
And, you know, Gary's obviously got them very well gelled together. Again, on Davo's video, there was interviews with Derby fans before the game as well. And this one lad just says, oh, what a cracking manager you've got. I can't wait to get him here.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? So,
but, you know, a lot of teams are going to be thinking that now. But the way we're going, we've just got to enjoy him while he's here and enjoy it while it lasts. The run we're on, but from Derby's point of view, I think the only thing they can do now is lick their wounds and regroup, go again.
We've got to regroup,
the very next game,
and win
the next game. Even if it's a scrappy 1-0,
it's a 6-pointer at Burnley.
You see the thing.
Oh well, that's a massive game. So they can't be moaning.
It's also very psychological football, isn't it? Because like your guys must be sitting there thinking, you know, last time Birmingham came. They did us like in the last minute of last minute of extra time, so to speak. This time they've turned us over good and proper. Yeah. Is our season going to fall apart again?
But they can't be thinking like that when they've got to go to Burnley in the next game. Yeah, it's live on Sky as well, isn't it? So
what day is that on?
I think next Monday.
Yeah, Monday night. Yeah. I think. Yeah. So you know they've got from now till the weekend to work on what went wrong against Blues. And
is that
at Burnley?
It's at Burnley.
We only drew at Derby.
We could organise you a coach just for yourself.
See, but when you've got a game like that, you've got no time to rest on your laurels. So.
No, because they come thick and fast.
Exactly. Mm. So they've got to be back on it.
Then we've got United the Friday.
Yeah.
And then the following week, a team that... playing results going anywhere. We've got Preston.
It's make or break them three games, isn't it, for part of your season? You know what I mean? Could be. Interesting times ahead. Interesting times ahead. What do you think of the new player we've brought in?
Buckley.
Hmm.
I like him. I think he's I think he's a good addition. You know, assuming it's a direct replacement for Gray. You know, someone who plays in a similar position. Someone who was looking really good in the Championship for Brighton, got his move to Sunderland possibly because of the Poyet connection at the time. I think Bridcut also went at the same time.
So
you know, Poyet saw a lot in him, enough to think that he could play in the Premier League. He hasn't been given a big chance by the managers that have followed, so he's come down to prove a few people wrong, hopefully, and to get some game time. And if he could fit straight in, then
a little bit disappointed on some of the reaction on social networks. I know we've only got the lad for a month, right? But he signed his... I know. Go on.
Well, I mean, it's a month. But if he's playing and if both parties are happy with it, then it'll be till the end of the season. You know, it's a month in writing, in principle. But, you know, if both sides of the deal are happy to continue it, then there's no reason that... it won't be till the end of the season.
Yeah, no, it's a bit annoying. Like, again, we talk about the power of social networks an awful lot, where everybody's absolutely perfectly entitled to their own opinion. But when the guy hasn't even kicked a ball for us, and he hasn't even done like a shift, and people are slating him and taking him down, leave the lad alone. Leave him alone.
I don't know why you'd be getting stick. You know, from Blues fans,
loads of it. Absolutely loads of it.
I don't understand that one bit because, well. You know, I think some Blues fans just need to remember where we are and
where we were.
So someone like Will Buckley, that is who, you know, I think we're pretty lucky to be able to get someone like Will Buckley in. You know, a lot of the talk over the last year has been about Rowett scouring the lower divisions for players. Well, we've just got a Premier League player on loan. He is a Sunderland registered player, and we've been able to get him on loan. Hopefully, till the end of the season.
Of course, got Terrell on loan as well.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's a really good addition. I think he'll excite the fans when he gets the chance. Showed a couple of nice touches in the 5 minutes he come on against Derby.
I think he might get more time against Ipswich.
Yeah, he might go straight in against Ipswich, but then.
But there is competition for places now, isn't there, as well?
Are you going to change that side?
I wouldn't. Would you want to give up it, wouldn't you, and put it out there?
I think he's going to struggle to break up that team that, that played against Dart. All right, it's at home rather than away from home, but you know, we'll be he'll be hoping that if he goes with the same team, then that clinical edge can remain.
Two more names for you. One is of course DJ Campbell.
He played for Derby, didn't he?
Yeah. Two games.
And Jerry Daly.
Jerry Daly,
the
German newspaper. Yeah.
Have we swapped goalkeepers at all ever? Any goalkeepers that you can think of that have played for both?
Kevin Poole.
I know, yeah.
Got the really? Arse now.
None others, no?
No.
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 Archie Gemmell.
Yeah.
Have we got him? Archie Gemmell?
We've got Archie, yeah. Archie,
all right, okay. Yeah. I missed that one. Yeah. My mistake. Yeah, but yeah, I wouldn't break that up for anything. Not you know, it's it because it just looked... It looked the team that we want. It looked... Yeah. It was just brilliant. Yeah, but...
Yeah, considering there's no Cottrell as well, he's out injured, and you know the bench looked quite strong with Buckley, Solomon, Otterbaugh, Shinney, Vaughan. You know all these players available. So you know there's been a lot of clamour for signings, but when you look at the actual 18 that are available on Saturday, plus someone like Cottrell who's out injured at the moment, there you know there's a lot of options, I think.
ELO says, I have another one, DJ Spall. Well, he did pick up a sporting injury at Derby.
Yeah.
He was being drunk, though, wasn't he?
It was sporting injuries. My stroke was injured, yeah, Chris. Yeah. I've overdone it. I've overstretched my vocal somewhat.
He's ruptured his epiglottis. He's a Uruguayan.
But you're right, as far as football is concerned, when I was a schoolmate, I'd got two left feet. And they were both pointing backwards, so I was absolutely useless. I couldn't help it. It was just one of the things I couldn't do. There you go.
Yeah, no, we believe you.
I mean, you don't know that, though, do you? You don't know that. Yeah. You don't know that at all.
No?
Not at all.
No.
Guess not. Any thoughts on the rumours today? We're looking at this young lad from Burton Albion.
Again, I think...
Do you know his name? He knows his name.
Amrati.
There you go.
Sorry?
I think he played quite well against us in the friendly we played against them, which may have caught his eye. Obviously, our management connection with Burton as well. Yeah, so
with having Duffy over there.
Yeah, exactly.
Already.
Sometimes, you know, it's easy to make links like that. I don't know, you know, enough about him to say. Sometimes you just don't know whether there'll be a success or not. But again, it's just rumours at the moment. So,
well, another rumour that was coming out was one from that your wife was researching this afternoon, Johnny. That somebody called Grealish is being
Grealish B6
to
you.
No,
yeah, yes.
Don't shoot the messenger. I only bought him in.
Was that in the Sun?
No, in the Birmingham Mail by the journalist called Brian Dick.
Oh yes. Oh, Biggie.
The font of all knowledge. Yeah.
Oh, Biggie. Well, see.
Yeah. Good luck with that. Good luck. Gary Wright might be a hero in Blues fans' eyes, but if that. Footballer ever set foot in a blue shirt?
Well, just
no.
Mickey
absolutely
Arthur?
Not.
Mickey it would make you laugh, though. It would make be ironic if he
yes after left Luton.
No, it wouldn't be ironic. No,
no, but the irony would be is if he came over and he blinded that championship inside out, and we went up and they went down.
No,
that would be ironic.
No, it wouldn't.
That would be ironic.
No, it wouldn't.
Do you think so, Chris?
No.
No
irony.
Absolutely not.
No irony.
No irony in that whatsoever.
Blower says, not sure. Are we looking at wingers? I think we should still be looking for six foot five centre half.
Well, there's another five. I'm not sure about, but yeah, definitely centre half.
Another name that you mentioned earlier, that somebody that you'd like in your team, will be Peter Crouch. Not doing a lot at Stoke at the moment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
coming towards the end of his career.
He's a prolific goal scorer, needs, whatever you say about
him.
Needs game time, definitely, because he's not getting it at Stoke, and I think he's been quite vocal about not getting game time at Stoke. There's definitely someone at, you know, even lower half of the Premier League, you know, could do with looking at someone like that. Definitely.
Is he not getting a game at all?
No, he's not.
Yes, only in the Capital One Cup. He's come on a few times.
But he's not getting a look in the league. So
it's suppose he's just happy picking up his wedge, I suppose.
Yellow says if he was to come to us, I'd buy Nick's pub all the beer in the land. You really don't want to make that statement, honestly.
No, you don't.
That's a statement.
Are we talking about
I should
the young man?
We're talking about Grealish.
Yeah. Look, this information didn't come from me, it came from his wife. Don't blame me, I only dragged him in.
I only gave him a lift. Birmingham Mail.
If the Birmingham Mail want to continue their charade of winding people up, then good luck to them. But that is not going to happen.
No.
Ever. Not a chance.
Okay, there you go. The voice of all reason, Mr. Chris Pugh, making that statement that will never happen. No,
fat man ever set foot. It was to ever sign a contract at Blows, I would resign my position
as
in the catering department.
Absolutely,
and I would refuse to enter that ground.
You've heard it
until
first,
the
yeah.
day he learns.
I'm not understanding this.
And you come to Derby's catering manager.
I'll sort Derby's mess out.
We're going to transfer it. Swapping catering managers.
Kevin Francis, there's another name.
Kevin Francis?
Yes, definitely, yeah, 6'7".
Yeah. He's for now in Canada, isn't he?
Yeah, Mountie. Met him at
Ongo, yeah. Is he on the Mountie division? Oh, he wouldn't need horse, he's that big, isn't he?
By the way, ELO, I can't repeat that joke you've just sent me, but thanks.
Was the joke on your phone?
Mm-hmm.
We'll have a look in a minute privately. Yeah. What would happen to all the burgers?
Exactly.
Yeah.
There'd be a derby.
Yeah. Actually, I'm glad I didn't go for anything to eat at Derby because I think I would have been livid. It would have been highlight of my show. It would have been the top. I just didn't want anything to eat. I
think my daughter went down somewhat. 10 minutes before half time to queue up to get a bottle, a couple of bottles. Just gave up. It was like 18 deep.
Poor show.
Terrible.
Half time, here we go.
Coming up to half time in injury time in first half, still 1-0 Swansea.
And that continues.
And with 20 minutes left, it's still Newport 1, Blackburn 1.
Does that go to a replay? That will go to a replay.
Because that is still a first.
I did want to actually highlight on tonight about the replays for the FA. Do you think that we should have replays nowadays in so many games? And there's
was he not listening?
You listened to last week's show, did you?
Clearly, in the garage, freezing me wrists off, trying to get the wheels sorted out. Did you cover that last week?
We covered this.
Shall we
last
skip
week?
That item, Chris?
If you want to ask me again,
let's float for a burger flipper. I'm loving the shout box tonight. Brilliant.
If ELO can provide the same coach for me every week to go to Derby, then I'll be more than happy. Yeah,
Dave Langan.
We've had David Langan.
We've had him. Yeah.
We've got. We're up to 20. So there's got to be. There must be loads. There you go. No, going back to the FA Cup, no, I think it should be finished on the night.
On the night, yeah.
Definitely.
And I disagreed.
You disagreed, didn't you?
Of course I did.
Yeah.
Of course you would.
Wouldn't be me without disagreeing with everyone.
You want to replay it.
I put the point out that...
It's the smaller clubs. It's a big payday, isn't it?
The teams should be allowed to discuss. So, for example, two of the third round ties were Blues v Bournemouth and Exeter v Liverpool.
Mm-hmm.
Blues v Bournemouth have a discussion before the game. I think if you had asked both parties, neither side would have wanted a replay. So you say to both parties, do you want a replay? Both parties say, no, we don't. Let's finish it on the day. Let them finish it on the day. Exeter, Liverpool, you ask both parties, do they want a replay? No. Liverpool say, no, we definitely don't want a replay. Exeter say, absolutely, we want a replay.
Give the decision to the home team.
No, because then it could have been Liverpool owned to Exeter.
But then Exeter would have taken their huge amount of money out of Liverpool for that
game.
But then
they get the chance to see, those Liverpool players at their home ground.
They also get the chance to win at Anfield.
You're saying to me, would you settle for a draw against United?
Well, Derby Man United. Yeah. Man United would probably say, no, we don't want the replay. Derby's a funny one because they're not exactly cash-strapped, but they probably would say, well, if it's 1-1 after 90 minutes, we'll go to Old Trafford rather than risk losing it on the day.
Mm.
You know, take 6,000 fans up to Old Trafford. But I think there should be a way where the FA consult both teams, and if it's in the best interest of both teams to not have a replay, then they should be allowed
contentious, to... Contentious, which is what I like, Chris, when I talk to you. I like contentious issues, you know.
Yeah,
can't beat it, can you? Can't beat it. Robbie Savage, there's another name.
Oh, there, yes. Yeah, Robbie.
Well. Yeah. I'll tell you what. Should have got that one. Definitely should have got that one.
I've got to say hello to Laura and to Dan's dad. There you go.
Hello, Laura and Dan's dad. Nice one. Thanks for listening in, guys. Okay,
forget,
so...
How did we forget Robbie Savage?
John Burridge.
Yeah. Budgie?
Budgie. Kenny Burns.
Of course, yeah. Kenny Burns. Oh, God. Yeah, mate, Kenny.
Yeah, he used to get the blacksmiths at
Yeah.
It's now half-time, 1-0 Swansea.
Okay, I'm going to listen to that one certainly all the way home. What I try and do is I only drive to the speed limits, Chris, when I go home, right?
As does everyone.
I can only speak for myself because I'm sitting in my vehicle looking at my speedometer.
Yeah. Right?
And there is a restaurant on the, as you go through Burton-on-Trent on the A38, there's a restaurant all lit up on the right-hand side. And that's usually where I get to when the game finishes. And if I'm ahead of that, I'm ahead of schedule. And if I'm behind that, I'm behind schedule. Hey, you know, that's how I know exactly where I am at all times, Chris. You're impressed with that.
Not really.
Oh, no. Really?
Of course, yeah. I remember that. I remember that when Kenny scored that four goals. There was one game where he scored four, and it was the first one to score four. Got a car or something. I think that might have been the game.
No, that was against Leicester City.
Is it?
Yeah, and I think it was six that we had to score.
All right.
I believe, and it was a toss up whether Trevor Francis or Kenny Burns won it.
Because I was
TR7. It was the car.
It was a TR7. You're right.
I don't remember that.
Yeah.
You're looking at me astounded. Pass. There you go. Okay. Can we have some predictions then for the impending games that are coming up this week? Firstly and foremostly, there is a massive game going on up the road tomorrow night, whereas those hopeful giant killers are coming into town, Wickham Wanderers.
Yep.
Chris Pugh.
3-0 Villa.
Right.
You've gone for 8? Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's got his sensible head on. He's
Yeah. I'm going to go for Wickham to sneak it. 1-0.
1-0 Wickham.
I'm going 1-1.
But then it will finish tomorrow night because it goes for extra times and penalties.
And Wickham on a penalty shootout.
Wickham on a penalty shootout.
All right, okay.
He's Bill Turnbull, the newsreader. Right. He's the director, isn't he?
He is, yeah, Bill Turnbull, news bloke, yeah. Yeah, that's my friend.
He is a savant. He's like a dictionary, isn't he? It's like an encyclopedia. It's like, it is Wikipedia all rolled into one.
And ELO's gone for Wickham 1-0.
I'd take that. I'd certainly take that. Yeah.
Gary Ablett played for Derby.
Gary Ablett.
He did.
He died very young.
Not long.
Did you?
Yeah.
Mm, Ablett. Well. Of course, we could have had Dave McKay, but he was management. Mm.
Yeah, both. Mm, yeah. But
did he play? Didn't play for Blues, did he?
Don't think he played for Blues, did he?
No.
I don't know.
No, he didn't play.
Dave McKay, no. I think he came straight in as
manager. No, he came from Tottenham.
That's all he did.
Does Mr. Bute want a charity bet?
Does a yellow one of... Trump bankrupt,
right? Okay, here we go. Somebody's just thrown the gauntlet.
What's the bet then?
Somebody's thrown the gauntlet bet. Down to you.
Name the bet.
B61, Wickham 2, SKC, George Blue 1-1, and the Vile on penalties. We will win 2-1 on Saturday. Terrell to score first. I'm going to go for 2-0 Blues on Saturday. 2-0 Birmingham on Saturday.
That'll What's be the present form of Ipswich?
1-1 draw.
They're scoring, aren't they?
They're the awkward team.
Yeah.
They are, you know, any Mick McCarthy side is going to battle hard.
Especially when the position they're in now.
Yeah.
They're six, aren't
Jim
they?
Jim Smith, of course, was manager for both as well. Yeah, the
Bald Eagle. Bald Eagle.
Yeah, 20 years since he got his promotion.
Is he alive still?
Yes, I think so.
Ipswich Town are actually top of the away form.
The away table. Okay.
Yeah. We beat them at Ipswich.
But aren't Birmingham top of the form table at the minute?
They're probably not.
I don't know. I'm referring to the whole season. They've played 13 games away from home and got 24 points. That's more points than anybody this season away from home.
Blue Hobbers going 1-0 Blues.
I will go.
We don't know what this gauntlet thrown down for you is, do we? We don't know what the,
no,
the
bet ELO is. He's got 5 minutes to name the bet.
Can we say well done to the Claws, who put on a fantastic first show at the Rainbow in Digbeth on Saturday. Brilliant young band. Well done to them. I'm sure you'll put them in touch with our good friend Gabby Cabby and the Biscuit Boys. Mm-hmm. If they're not already, Lee Bradbury? Yeah, good one. Yeah. Good one. Yeah, right, you can have B6 and the Tilton Talk Show will have Wickham. £25.
What happens to the draw? Void. Null and void draw.
I don't
after
know.
After 90 minutes. Or qualifying.
Don't know.
I'm not liking the optimism from everybody tonight, so I'll go Ipswich to win 2-1. Oh. On Saturday.
You're almost hated, aren't you?
McGoldrick. McGoldrick.
We go through that together on Saturday.
You would have to be catering a dog.
We go, yeah. I'll be forced out.
We go through all that emotion on Saturday. And then you come back and by Monday, your head's gone down again, man.
Yeah.
Can't believe it. 2-1 on Saturday to Blues. Mags with the winner. That would be absolutely superb if that was the case. 2-2 for George Blue. Would that be a bad result? 2-2 to get in, you know.
I think a point. I mean, I've just
against them is good.
They've got more points than anybody on the road this season. So I think a point. You know, and then we go. We've got Bristol City away. If we get a point at Ipswich, get home to Ipswich, beat Bristol City away, we're still in the mix. We're still in and about there. So I don't think a draw would be a terrible result.
No, I think we're going into it, you know, on the back of a cracking win.
I'll be happy absolutely with a draw at Burnley.
That's what the back of them. That's one thing. Yeah. So are you going to revise your prediction there? Based on what Chris has just said there?
No.
He was nodding. And then he said no. Draw the Tilton Talk Show, put the 25 in the charity pot. Crikey, that's not a bad odds, is it?
So, you're... Okay.
It's going to cost you either way because you're part of the Tilton Talk Show.
No, it's not.
This show's costing you a fortune this season. No. Thanks to my brother.
Just to confirm, just quickly to confirm, if Villa win...
Here you go, here's mine then, I'll throw this one. If Wickham win, I'll stick a fiver in the pot straight away. There you go.
Okay.
Oh yeah. I'm there, yeah.
Gladly.
If Wickham win, gladly. I'll put a fiver in as well then, yeah.
There you go.
That's 15.
Yeah. Come on, give us your fivers.
Yeah, can we have a Tilton Talk Show? If Wickham win, everybody contributes a fiver towards the Just Giving page. How about that?
You ought to say to ELO, if Wickham win, you'll pay your bar bill next time.
I'll have a dry month before I go out. Yeah. He'll be so sorry. He will be so sorry.
Who's ELO? It's his brother.
Yes.
Yeah.
Electric Light Orchestra.
Yeah, oh, I know that. Jeff Lynne, yeah.
He's the ugly one.
Yeah.
Ugly one of the family. There's always one.
He's not in the Lady ELO, though, is he?
No. He's far too ugly for that.
He used to be the Mighty Avengers before they were the ELO.
Correct.
Music as well. You as well,
correct, yes. I knew that as well, yeah.
Oh, you want 20? Yeah.
Well, this has been the Tilton Talk.
Jerry Levine.
Yeah, on a very strange Monday night where our adopted strange Derby friend, Rockin Jonny, friend of the show.
Friend of the show.
Still friend of the show.
You made him come back.
That means that well, it looks like you're staying down.
10 minutes left. Blackburn beating Newport 2-1.
Ooh, okay.
Oh, dear.
If we do play each other next year, then you'll be very welcome to come back, Johnny, and tell
you
us about all your exploits over the close season and the summer.
Yeah.
And good luck with your constant money raising. I know you do some fantastic work, mate, for the locals. It's always appreciated. I don't play football myself, but you know, I've got.
Thanks for having me.
How much is it so far? Because I know it was a lot of money last time you said that you've raised altogether so far
in the 40 years.
Yeah.
Up towards £750,000.
Oh,
up towards £750,000 for charity, basically. For charity. One of those, isn't it? Rockin Jonny, it's a pleasure to have you, and I'm so glad that we were three that were smiling more than you. But he's got a bus pass.
Okay.
With Her Majesty.
Rockin Jonny with Her Majesty the Queen. There you go.
Fantastic.
No, buddy, thanks for coming in, dude. We'll see you in the pubs in town.
I thought I was going to get annihilated, but
we're not like that.
No, you've been very good.
What it is
off mic.
we
wait till the show's finished.
The only thing we can say is that we came, we conquered.
Yeah, we did.
This has been the Tilton Talk Show. Chris Brown, thank you very much for having us.
No problem.
Mr. Pugh, thanks ever so much again for your superior knowledge and your negativity towards Ipswich game.
As always.
Rockin' Jonny, thanks buddy. Cheers.
Thank you very much
and,
indeed.
From my good self to you all. Good night, God bless. See you next week. And don't forget, keep right on to the end of the road. I might have a voice next week.
Good night.